Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islanders represent 2% of Australia's entire population, while making up 28% of the country's full-time prison population. A new multi-million dollar initiative from the New South Wales government will support inmates upon their release in the hope of reducing these numbers dramatically. Tara Callinan has more.
For many inmates, the outside world is far more challenging than life behind bars. And the New South Wales Attorney General is fed up with that harsh reality.
The problem is, are we achieving outcomes when people come out? Well, probably not. I'm frustrated when I visit our prisons to see just how many Aboriginal people there are in our prisons at the moment. 2% of the population, but in places like, well, in some prisons, I won't name them, anything up to 80 or 90%.
Inmates here at the Silverwater Correctional Complex and many others from across New South Wales will now benefit from a $17 million support package upon their release back into the community. But Brad Hazard says early intervention is just as important.
I think we need to have a much more supportive approach long before people end up in prison. And any programs we can address in that regard, well, I'll be in it.
With 76% of all Indigenous prisoners serving time more than once, Minister Hazard hopes his latest initiative will reduce rates of reoffending.
I'm working with Treasury at the moment. We're looking at all sorts of options in terms of programs. One of the issues for us, of course, and we do have to make sure when using taxpayers' dollars that they work, is making sure that the programs come to us with a serious business plan and an opportunity to be evaluated.
But the government's own programs appear to be failing Koori people. To access the drug and alcohol treatment program, for example, a person must serve at least 12 months inside to qualify for support. However, the average length of stay of an Indigenous inmate is just 96 days.
One of the issues is that we have a high number of Aboriginal people in prison on, for example, driving offences. In the remote parts of New South Wales, it could be, for example, and I've had examples like this already, where you might have a woman who is otherwise a very good mother, a very good family member looking after her children, but has never had a licence. Why? Well, it may be because she never had a birth certificate at all, or it may be because she wasn't able to afford to have a birth certificate, or it may be because she simply doesn't want to have to go to a government office.
Drug and substance abuse also contribute to high Indigenous incarceration rates. But Minister Hazard says his multi-million dollar support package will link users with appropriate health services despite how long they spend locked up. Tara Callinan, NITV News.